saying that's what I want.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Oh, even better.
Mission accomplished. Now Cameron can see exactly what Nat is about to eat on top of her morning biscuits, a packet of crisps, and a bowl of leftover Chinese with fried rice, chicken curry, and king prawns.
So what we've got here is a large Coke. We've got large fries. We've got a large chicken sandwich, two double cheeseburgers, onion rings, and these are all the sauces to go with that. So this is exactly the same as what she ordered.
This whole meal comes in at a massive 2,520 calories. Natalie's home alone with just a takeaway for company. After finishing her fast food meal, she tries to hide the evidence from boyfriend Andrew. But Cameron has her rumbled.
Oh, it's so sly. I can't believe it.
When you nipped to McDonald's and had that double chicken burger and the onion rings and all those sauces, we've got the sauces here. And in just these two bags, Natalie, there's 280 calories.
No.
Just in sauces alone. So forget the meal, you're scoffing. Just in sauces alone.
I have that all the time.
300 calories just in that. Is it fair to say that you quite like to enjoy yourself and treat yourself at the weekends as well? So let's just have a look at this.
It's better not be Saturday night.
Oh, yeah. No, let's not watch this.
Oh, God.
Like 92% of dieters, Saturday is Natalie's day off watching what she eats. It's 10 a.m. And the first bit of evidence is in, courtesy of Natalie's boyfriend, Andrew.
Excellent. Two sausages wrapped in bacon and filled with cheese.
Later in the day, we catch her clocking up two whisper bars and a coffee. And then she's off out for another cup of coffee and a slice of chocolate and banana cake. It's 4:30, and our PI has tracked Natalie down to a fried chicken joint. Where she's got a takeaway for herself and Andrew.
Right, I've got exactly the same order.
Natalie's half of the takeaway consisted of a large portion of fries, beans, fried mini breast fillets, a chicken burger with a hash brown, and lots of sachets of sauces. Up to this point, Natalie has consumed around 3,500 calories. That's already 1.5 times a woman's recommended daily allowance. An evening of alcohol follows, adding another 1,600 calories. And Natalie ends her night with a fry.
Your pill. It is 90, but I'm resting only 2 minutes between the sets. So I already did six sets, yeah, and now like I'm going to do the same with biceps.
Fried chicken wrap and chips covered in sauce and a large bar of chocolate for dessert.
But we've worked out that on Saturday alone, this Saturday just gone, you ate... I can't believe this. Do you want to guess how many calories?
4,000.
Nearly 7,000 calories.
Just
in
on
one
Saturday?
Day. Which is enough for over three women.
Wow.
In one day.
It's quite scary realising how much I've had. That I've had three women's worth of calories in one day. Oh, I've got no idea how much I was eating. I don't think I really realised just how much I was sort of packing away, really. But seeing that on film and seeing myself on film, oh, it's horrendous.
Any thoughts so far?
Just looking at myself on there, thinking.
Yeah? It's not nice, because when you...
It's awful. I just think I look quite unhappy as well. And I wanted that. I wanted to see myself. But I didn't think I looked that bad. Just look at us all there and think we're as bad as each other, aren't we?
Don't get up
upset.
I just want to do the yard.
Today's the start of a new...
Don't worry, I'm not going to
do it. A new diet.
And I don't want to look like that.
I know how upsetting it can be and how frightening it can be. But I promise you, all of you, you've got expert help here. We want to help you. We want you to be the people you want to be.
It just upset me seeing myself like that on film. It's almost like I didn't recognise the person I was watching. I didn't realise that's how I look. So I'm definitely ready. Bring on the apples.
Natalie is a classic emotional eater. She uses food to enhance positive emotions, such as celebrating the start of the weekend, and to combat negative feelings like stress, loneliness, and boredom. If you're an emotional eater, remember cravings only last about 20 minutes, so distract yourself until the urge to eat passes. Also, identify your triggers. Whether it's a hard day at the office or your football team's just lost a match, make a conscious effort to avoid comfort food completely. Try going for a walk or keeping your hands and mouth busy by phoning a friend for a chat. Natalie's food diary said she was averaging an intake of 3,230 calories a day, but her filmed daily average was over 4,500. Now faced with her secret eating, will she finally be able to change her habits? Natalie will start a 10-week healthy eating plan. She'll be aiming to bring her calories down to 1,800 a day, binning the takeaways and curbing her weekend blowouts. Across this series, we've been giving you some handy hints on how we can all eat less, if we make some small changes to our behaviour. And this week, we're off to the supermarket.
Now, I have to confess, most of the time when I'm in a supermarket, I'm in full control. But then, I'll confess, there are certain times when I just seem to have a meltdown, where I suddenly find myself reaching for the bad boys. High fat, high sugar, high salt snacks that I have just got to have. And the thing is, I don't really know why I do it.
Chartered psychologist Dr. David Lewis thinks he might have some answers.
Why are we here today, then? What are you going to say to
me? Well, we're going to be looking at how people shop in a supermarket, and what I'm interested in is the kind of food choices we make and how these food choices can actually lead to us overeating.
Right, OK.
And the key thing here is whether you're shopping when you're hungry.
I've heard that this before, that if you go shopping when you're hungry, you buy more, blah, blah, blah. But I kind of thought it was a bit of a myth.
Not at all.
It's scientifically proven.
Absolutely, and what's more, you'll actually go when you're shopping when you're hungry, you'll go for things which are high in fat and high in sugar, because they'll give you that quick energy buzz, you know, that hit.
Well, it all sounds absolutely plausible in theory, and I can attest to being hungry and, you know, buying bad foods, but we need to test it.
We do.
This is going to be an interesting one,
yes.
I think.
We'll have to see what happens.
So that's the theory. Now we're going to put it to the test. We've asked 16 volunteers to take part in an experiment. They've been split into two groups of eight. For the morning, we're keeping each group in separate rooms. They think they're here to take part in an experiment which tests their behaviour whilst performing a series of tasks. But they're not. Group one has access to healthy snacks to munch on throughout the morning to keep them going. But the second group hasn't. All they've got is water. And after 3 hours without food, they should be feeling pretty hungry. And this is where the real experiment begins. We've given each of our volunteers a tenner. And now they're about to be let loose in the supermarket to buy their lunches. Dr. David will be recording exactly what's going into each of our volunteers' baskets. He'll then be able to calculate how many calories and how much fat each of our two groups has gone for.
Oh, some donuts and some toffees.
Yeah. All I need is sugar. I'm not, like, really hungry, but I just want, like, my energy level.
Why do you need sugar? Have you not eaten anything today?
No.
So you're hungry?
Yes.
If Dr. David's theory is correct, then our hungrier group should put more food with more calories and more fat into their baskets. Later, we'll be back to find out how our groups got on. Over the past 5 days, the Meakin family from the Midlands has been under 24-hour
surveillance. I can eat almost everything.
To understand why they're
instead
so
of like some kind of like literally bullshit food.
We've gathered evidence of their mindless munching and brought them to the secret eaters incident room.
I already like explained it many times on stage.
Natalie was the first to face the music. Next up will be Mum Sue. Since having her children with husband Joe, 17 stone 5 Sue has been fighting the battle of the bulge and losing.
I've been married to the same man for 30 years. He loves me no matter what shape, size or weight I am. So I think that's part of the problem, really, because I know he loves me no matter what. So you do let yourself go.
According to Sue's food diary, she has a healthy diet, including pieces of fresh fruit. During the period before filming, she recorded eating, on average, a slimming 1,900 calories a day. Is she a medical mystery, or did our cameras catch some secret eating?
Sue, you said to me last week that you didn't think that you were eating that much to justify why you're 17 stone. So let's just have a look at your first issue.
The house cameras showed that Sue cooked several nutritious meals for herself and husband Joe. Her three meals a day added up to between 1,500 to 1,800 calories. Well within the recommended daily allowance for a woman. So just where are those secret calories coming from? Over the course of the surveillance, our cameras picked up Sue drinking several cups of coffee. But just look at what she has with them. In 5 days, Sue ate a number of chocolate bars and biscuits whilst having a cuppa. Our dietitian worked out that this adds up to just under 200 extra calories a day. Sue's not alone. 89% of 45 to 54-year-olds admit to having a biscuit or chocolate bar with their cuppa. So what is it about chocolatey treats that makes us love them so much? Food scientist Richard Marshall in the Secret Eater's Lab has the answer, and it all happens in the mouth.
All chocolate melts at just a
without
little
it, it
will
be just fucked up. Like, it would be much, much more terrible. This is like kind of smooth.
34, 35 degrees.
Because so all the damage takes all these gloves.
In our mouth to melt. And that gives a cooling sensation, very slight, which we like. We like that feel of it. And then it gives a coating around the mouth, which again is nice and pleasurable, a sort of lubricating effect.
New studies suggest a brisk 15-minute walk can suppress chocolate cravings and reduce your intake by half. But if you can't kick the habit, opt for lower-calorie treats like Milky Way or a fudge bar.
No, you're not having chocolate. You don't need it. Get fruit.
I'm the coffee.
Ever since suffering a heart attack, Sue's husband Joe has eaten more healthily. Worried for Sue's health, he now tries to stop her from eating too many sugary snacks.
I'll have a coffee. Don't be following me in here. Don't be following me. Do you want a whisper? Yeah. Do you want half?
Put it back.
To share it. Come on.
Put it back.
You don't understand what you mean.
I'm watching you.
And when she can't get her own way with a chocolate bar, she downgrades to a biscuit.
I know it's funny, but can you see what you're doing?
Yeah, I know it's sugar, but I kid myself that that's the only sugar I have in a day then, you see.
Well, it's not. It's not.
Sue is a classic tea time treater, reaching for a sweet snack with a cuppa. If you're one of these types, you should eat regularly to stop your blood sugar levels from dropping too low and triggering that urge for chocolate or biscuits. And try breaking the association by changing your choice of cuppa to something like a herbal tea.
Having seen what you've seen today, what are you discovering about yourself, do you think?
Maybe I shouldn't eat chocolate.
Your big issue, Sue, is your secret snacking. And you know it's bad, otherwise you wouldn't be whispering and trying to hide it from Joe. So we will tackle that and show you, really, that if you do need to snack, then there are healthier options that you can go for.
I think you kid yourself a bit about what you eat and don't eat, and I'm obviously eating more than I think.
Over the next 10 weeks, Sue will be on a diet plan aiming for 1,900 calories a day. Our dietitian has worked out if Sue could just kick her tea time treat habit, she could lose up to 1.5 stone in 12 months. Earlier on, we set up an experiment to find out if shopping when you're hungry makes you put more unhealthy, fatty foods and therefore more calories into your basket. We split our volunteers into two groups and kept them busy for a morning. One group grazed on snacks and the other went hungry. Then at lunchtime, they were all given £10 each and let loose in the supermarket to buy whatever they wanted.
David has been monitoring both the teams. So, the shoppers who've been fed healthy snacks throughout the morning who aren't particularly hungry, but also the ravenous, starved ones that we've denied any food whatsoever who are now very tired and irritable. Will they pick more food and also the high-calorie foods that David has predicted? It's time to find out. David.
Yes.
The results are in.
They are.
Please tell me they are astounding and they've worked.
Well, the maths has all been done and the results I think you'll find quite amazing. I was amazed myself. Those who shopped while they were hungry, because we hadn't given them anything to eat all day, they ate 300% more.
That's
300% more in terms of calories and 400% more in terms of the amount of fat they consumed.
That massively, massively proves the theory, doesn't
absolutely.
It?
Absolutely. They were really going for high-fat items which would give them that burst of energy. They ate just over 2,500 calories each per person, which is, you know, for a man, that's all he should eat in the course of the day.
Just for lunch?
Yeah, just for lunch. But the interesting thing was, Anna, that they had the health, those who had some snacks during the day to keep them going, they only ate 370 calories. They were healthy snacks. Yet when they came into the supermarket, it made that vast difference. It meant they ate 700 calories rather than 2,500 calories.
So again, if you are a little bit worried about your weight,
yeah.
A good tip is whether you are shopping in the supermarket, whether you are ordering a takeaway, yeah. Whether you're in a restaurant or just cooking at home, yeah. Make sure you've had some snacks beforehand, healthy snacks, and you will significantly reduce your calories.
Absolutely.
Hello, shoppers. Okay, I have got a confession to make. You lot think that you were brought down here to take part in a behavioural study. That was a bit of a porky lie. You are taking part in a behavioural study, but actually, what we're looking at is how you behave when you go into a supermarket when you're hungry. Okay.
Three times as much. That makes me feel a bit ill.
Three times, wow.
Amazing. And scary.
And don't ever go shopping when you're hungry.
That's scary though.
Never.
Right. I didn't think yeah, I was being that much.
Yeah, I didn't realise, but yeah.
I think it may help to change my whole lifestyle. And I'm really grateful for that. It's been a great day.
Oh, David. Yep. You've been very quiet throughout all of this. We come to you finally.
17 stone 4 chef Dave has no idea why he's overweight, but he has good reason to worry about it.
Dad had a heart attack. That was probably due to too much greasy, fatty foods and too much beer, which December 26, I'm going down the same road as that. Look in the mirror, generally, I feel repulsed. Feel down on myself. It's one of those days.
Dave's food diary showed a calorie intake of around 1,700 a day. But just to maintain his current weight, he would have to be eating nearly double that amount. So, over the past 5 days, we've put Dave under close surveillance in an attempt to get to the bottom of why he is 17 stone, 4 pounds. Our house cameras revealed that on a typical work day...
Hello.
Evening.
Dave gets home at 8 p.m.
You having something to eat now? to that, I might do.
And his evening meal consists of not much more than a burger, a chocolate bar, and an ice cream. Not the most nutritious meal, but neither the most calorific. On an average evening, Dave is consuming between 1,000 and 1,200 calories from his evening meal. So why is he piling on the pounds?
Are you eating at all during the day?
Sometimes I might grab a quick sandwich.
Quick sandwich?
If I'm working, there will be a quick sandwich.
Let's just have a look at what kind of sandwich we're talking about here, Dave.
After it became apparent that Dave wasn't putting away the calories at home, our PI Duncan was given the task of finding out what was going wrong. We managed to track down one of Dave's work colleagues at the pub. And just before Dave tucked into a quick bite at work, Duncan's mole snapped his snack and texted the picture to us.
There you go.
That's a sandwich?
That's a flatbread, yeah, that's a sandwich. It's on a big TV, it looks bigger.
In that sandwich alone, 1,000 calories, Dave.
How have you figured that one out?
Because we've got an expert on that.
Our expert dietitian, Lynn Garten, has analysed a sandwich identical to Dave's.
So here, we've got roughly about 200 grams of fried chicken.
It's very, very... And guys, I was wondering if it is like possible to do 12 sets in 35 minutes, like including one big group as a chest and another as like little one as a muscles. Yeah, it just perfectly fits. As you could see, like I had a timer set over here and it was like exactly like 34 to 35 minutes. Like I didn't skip a set, like I even did one warm-up set, but before the stream, yeah, I did push-ups. And then I started immediately with the working weight. I didn't prepare my body, like I didn't improve the weight little by little. I didn't start with the 50, 60, 70. I just started with a 90 kilogram on my chest and I just did six sets. After that, we just rested 2 minutes and did another six sets for my muscle, for my biceps group. So perfectly. I think like it is the best way like to train because you don't need to invest too much of your time doing training, and as you can see, like after complete like 50 minutes, you like less than an hour, you can actually like take a shower and even eat something. So it's just perfect. And training is intense, so which means you can decrease the weight a little bit on the bar because like you resting very short time. So perfect. I probably would, I can like lift much more on a bench press, but I will stick to 90 kilograms until I would do 10 reps in each set. Or at least like in 4 out of 6. So like in each set, I have to be able to lift 10 or even like 12. Because first of all, it is safe for your muscles, like they're not going to be torn, you know, and your joints also safe. if you just would rapidly increase the weight, so it's like not good. Taking into account that we are not warming up way too intensively, you know. Like it's like literally almost without the warm-up, one set of push-ups, it's like around 60 reps, and your shoulders, elbow, triceps, and chest all already involved when you're doing the push-ups. So the blood is getting to the muscles, so and you're pretty much ready to...
Будь здорово!
And you're pretty much ready to work with the weight. So at this beautiful note, actually, we'll start the stream. I didn't want like to go live at all. I just was wondering if it's even possible to do it on stream, because I knew that the chat might be one of the reasons you cannot be fit inside that time. So guys, see you next time. I'm not sure, probably like if I won't fall asleep the next 2 hours, I guess I probably might start another one, just read something or play games. I'm not sure. It's like very deep night right now. It is 2 a.m. and I don't want to go sleep at all. Like I'm literally don't want to. So I will see, like if I won't sleep, I will start the stream. If I will go sleep, I won't. So bye. Thanks everyone.